Omar's asked, how do you choose the right wire gauge to use on different sensors or on upgraded options such as fuel pumps, fuel injectors, etc.? Good question there, Omar, and this is one of the most common ones we get asked, and fortunately it's not actually that difficult, particularly if we've got a good understanding of Ohm's law. So what we need to do before we can work out the correct wire gauge is we need to work out what the current draw in a particular circuit is going to be. Let's start by talking about sensors, because these are pretty particular. And if we're talking about sensors such as our fuel pressure, manifold pressure, throttle position, etc., the gauge of wire in these is not actually particularly critical, because they draw such a small amount of current. So we don't need a big gauge of wire to support these. Typically, we're going to be using somewhere around about 22 gauge. If you want to go a little bit lighter in your wiring harness, you could very easily drop down to 24 gauge or even smaller without danger for the current that's going to be supported. The problem we need to weigh up here when we are choosing the gauge of wire to use is as we go to lighter gauge wire, the wire gets smaller, the mechanical strength of the wire starts to suffer. So we need to really weigh up the weight of our wiring harness with the mechanical strength. And what I'm getting at here is, particularly if you're not working on the wiring harness yourself, if you're relying on a mechanic, sometimes mechanics can be accidentally a little bit rough, and if they leave an item hanging off the wiring harness, if you're using a very light gauge of wire, it can be enough to actually damage the harness. So generally 22 gauge is a nice compromise there. That is definitely not going to work for your fuel pump though. Fuel pumps, depending on the specific pump that you are using, can easily draw 10 to 15 amps, sometimes much, much more than that. Key here is to look at the manufacturer's documentation for that pump. And another thing you need to understand, particularly on turbocharged engines, if you are running a manifold pressure referenced fuel pressure regulator, bit of a mouthful, but essentially what that means is as we come up onto boost, the fuel pressure increases, which means the pump has to work harder. What this can mean is that at high boost, the pump is actually going to be drawing more current, so we need to factor that in. So once we know what the current draw on a circuit is, how do we choose the wire gauge? Well, within our courses, we've got a nice convenient table of wire gauge versus length versus temperature versus maximum current handling capabilities. So that's a nice reference, but honestly, if you search on Google for a similar thing, you're going to find many, many sort of guides to what gauge of wire is going to be suitable for what application. As long as you're giving yourself a bit of safety margin there, you should be good to go. That question was taken from one of our free live lessons. If you like free stuff and you're the type of guy who wants to expand your knowledge, click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson. You'll learn about performance engine building and EFI tuning, and you'll also have the chance to ask your own questions, which I'll be answering live. Remember, it's 100% free, so follow the link to claim your spot.